every perception of employer, every perception of individual will have a greater influence on their business. It can be an employer, or it can be a safety practitioner, or it can be any person. But every person's perception will have an impact on their environment. So I have took an analysis and I found this 10 common misconceptions that may found among the owners, among the individuals, which may have greater influence on the business. In this video, I'm going to explain you 10 common misconceptions related to health and safety and the actual solution which you can take to grow your business. Misconception that I would like to discuss is worker causes accident. Of course, I agree. The unsafe activities and violations of the worker will lead to accident. But the legal requirements places the duty over the employer to prevent human error and violations in the workplace through the careful design of work equipment and work environment. So the message I would like to convey to you is the worker will never cause an accident, but the primary failures such as the lack of training, lack of proper recruitment plan, lack of provision of safe equipments, lack of enforcement of safety rules, lack of maintenance plan, lack of sufficient allocation of resources, these are all the primary failure that led to the unsafe activity of the worker that result into an accident. So never blame the worker for the accident. Instead, what you can do to prevent this misconception is investigate the accidents, find the root causes and eliminate the root causes. So never blame the worker for the harm which happened in your workplace. The second misconception that exists among the employer is health and safety costs a lot, but it gives less benefit to the company. If you are an employer, if you are any management team, with this opinion in mind, change it as soon as possible. Single fire incident can damage your entire company, can make you bankrupt. So make sure you never underestimate the importance of health and safety in your company. Though you are earning good amount from your business, it's useless if you haven't controlled the unnecessary losses. Health and safety will always have the greater impact on your business, on your customers, on your employees, which is always profitable. The third misconception that exists among the employer is my company runs with minimal risk, so no safety department is required. My answer to this misconception is no business is safe here. There is no exception under the legal requirement. All the companies have to follow the legal requirements which is imposed by their respective national government. So you can be a small business or you can be a multinational company. Irrespective of your size, irrespective of your type of business, you have to follow the legal requirements. Of course, you have to make sure the minimal safety requirements are implemented in your company. So don't think your company is small, so you don't need a safety department. If your national government haven't insisted the appointment of safety officers in your company, make sure at least you have access to the safety consultants who can assist you in the implementation of minimal safety requirements. The fourth misconception that exists among the employer, that exists among the individual, is safety is all about common sense. For this misconception, my answer is, of course, the common sense will have a greater influence in the prevention of accident. But common sense itself decided by number of factors, like the educational qualification of the person, the previous experience of the person, their attitude and their stress level on that particular situation. So the common sense itself will vary from time to time, depends on their stress level on that particular moment. So don't think safety is only about common sense. The safety is having endless number of strategies beyond common sense. That's the reason the specialists have invented multiple analytical techniques rather than simply trusting on the common sense. Some of the analytical technique that I would like to remember viewers fault tree analysis, event tree analysis, failure mode effect analysis. These are all analytical techniques that came into picks only to prove that the common sense alone will never help to prevent the accidents in the workplace. So don't think the common sense alone is sufficient to prevent the accidents in the workplace. My solution for this misconception is don't rest on the common sense. Instead, make sure all your employees are provided with job-specific training in order to take right action in any situation, irrespective of their stress level, irrespective of their mental state on that particular moment. Train them on the specific to the job, their hazard and the control measures. Don't only trust on the common sense. Instead, use the analytical techniques which is available for you to improve your health and safety performance. The fifth misconception that exists among the employer is, I have insured everything, so the no safety department is required. For this misconception, my answer is, the HSE estimates state that the ratio between insured and uninsured cost range between 8 to 36%. In the sense, if you found that you have lost 1 lakh rupee as an insured cost from the accident, the actual cost that you have lost will be ranged from 8 lakh rupee to 36 lakh rupee, which is completely uninsured. So don't think that you have insured everything. There are certain costs which you cannot able to get from your insurance company, like hiring new employee, provision of training and criminal fines, for which you will not get the insurance from your insurance company. For this misconception, my solution is, make sure either you have appointed the safety officer or you had access to the safety consultant who can assist you in the prevention of accidents in your workplace. The sixth misconception that exists among the employer, that exists among the individual, is believing that safety is only about PPE, personal protective equipment. For this misconception, my answer is, of course, the personal protective equipment is having its own role in the health and safety. But personal protective equipments alone will never help you to improve your health and safety performance, will never help you to prevent the accidents. Of course, most of the personal protective equipment which you are using in your industry will never prevent the accident. The personal protective equipment itself having its own limitations. One of the simple limitations that I would like to remember you is, if you have given the helmet to your employee to reduce the severity of injury from the falling of objects. Of course, this helmet will help to reduce the severity of injury, but it will never prevent the falling of object. You should have separate control for preventing the falling of objects. The other limitations are, the personal protective equipments are not comfortable in most of the cases. In some cases, eventually it can create a stress to your employees. So don't believe only the personal protective equipments are safety. There are huge amount of techniques available related to health and safety which you can incorporate to prevent the incidents in your workplace. The seventh misconception that exists among the employer and safety practitioner is believing that the zero incidents are not possible. If you ask me whether zero incidents is possible, my answer is yes, it is possible. If a day can be managed without any incident, of course, the same principle can be applied for all the upcoming days. The zero incidents can be achieved by the careful design of workplace, work equipment and work pattern. So don't shout the zero incidents are not possible. Instead, incorporate the right technique into your business to achieve zero incidents. The eighth misconception that exists among the safety practitioner and employer is believing that no accidents is only about high health and safety performance. See, if you had this misconception, high health and safety performance is only about having no accidents in your company, for your misconception, my answer is, the health and safety performance is not only about having zero accidents in your company. You cannot measure your company health and safety performance only based on the accident rates. If you wanted to measure the health and safety performance of your company, instead of only focusing on the accident rate, also focus on the other outputs related to health and safety, like the absenteeism rate, the staff turnover rate, the worker complaints rate, the near miss rate, the civil claim rate, the criminal fines rate. So don't only focus on the accident rate, and don't believe that health and safety performance is only about reducing the accident rate. The ninth misconception that exists among the safety practitioner, that exists among the employer, is safety is only about punish, fine and regulate. If you had this misconception, my answer to this misconception is safety is not only about punishing the workers. Only by giving punishment to the workers, only by emphasizing the rules over the workers, you can never achieve the 100% safety in your company. If you are an employer or safety practitioner trying to achieve the high health and safety performance by only punishing the workers, I wanted to convey you the strong message is you can never achieve 100% safety in your company. Of course, the disciplinary actions will have an influence on your workers, but it will not be for long time. The workers will follow the rules only when they know the reason why the rules are deployed. So instead of punishing the workers, make sure you have given enough importance to educate your workers. Educate your workers why the safety is important. Educate your workers if they haven't followed the safety, what will happen. The 10th misconception that exists among most of the experienced candidate is it won't happen to me. If you had this misconception with you, for this misconception, my answer is, remember, the accidents and incidents are common to everyone, will happen to anyone at any point of time. The research says, as experience increases, the amount of carelessness is also increases. So the experienced candidate are more prone to take lethargical actions and they are more prone for incidents too. So don't believe that the accidents will never happen to you. Of course, the accidents will happen to anyone at any point of time. So the solution is don't work lethargically. Make sure that you are following the safe system of work which is given to you. Make sure you are working as per the safety standard. The question from the video is, what is the most common misconception that present in your company as of now, and what action that you have taken to prevent it? Thank you.